not sure if he can handle it consistently because it is a demanding mistress that doesn't take no for an answer and is on call 24 hours. And so it makes you a little bit more paranoid than you used to, doesn't it? And now we're being looked upon as we have to deliver something. The minute you go outside, ooh, let me look a certain way, I'm famous now.
Hey, what you need is a little. Hey, what you get is no tomorrow. Hey, what you need, you have to borrow.
It was this rock star thing you once described it as being a dreadful existence.
Oh, in a sort special. Of a very luxuriant mental hospital.
So you can rehearse in there.
Where you're sort of put in a padded room and meals are brought to you. And the only time you sort of let out on your lead is when you're supposed to go and earn money for just about everybody else except yourself.
Reject you first.
Babe. David enjoyed being a star. I would say what he said to me. It's great when you want to get tickets for a concert, when you want to get backstage and see your friends, or if you want a good table at a restaurant. But the rest of the time, it's a pain in the ass. And I think that's pretty much a verbatim quote. I watched him deal with it too many times. That was his view on it.
I find this an incredible intrusion. Fuck off.
You know that's the only bit we're going to use, don't you?
Yeah. I know where the Pickney lines.
Once he experienced the fame and all that comes with that, I think he was done with it. He was done with it. And I think he realized he made a deal with the devil and it would be the rest of his life trying to undo that.
Happy hump day,
folks. I didn't get humped. You?
Yeah.
Some people, huh? They just get lost.
Well, it's more exciting than anything we've got around here.
Oh, I wouldn't say that. We have a nice life.
We have a nice life.
The idea that he had for the Stars Are Up Tonight video was that there were celebrities that were stalking normal people to study them. And then he whipped out the photograph of Tilda Swinton, and I was like, okay, that's fantastic. You know, him and Tilda were to play the normal couple. David really wanted to play the androgyny card because, you know, I mean, he is the androgynous being that we've grown up with. So Rick has boys in the girls' parts and girls in the boys' parts.
At that stage, I think he was able to definitely sit back and reflect on what fame meant. And I think that song, in a way, is kind of like, that's why it's like Stars Are Never Sleeping. It's like you can't escape it.
Eventually, the celebrities, they are their home. And when they come into the home, there's a transfer that happens. And now the normal people are dressed like celebrity, and the celebrities have succeeded in becoming the normal people. You know, as an artist, you collect things, and he's had years of not having to put things out, so he's collecting things. He wants to sort of hold up a mirror and say, hey, look at this over here, look at this over here, and, you know, comment on it, but make it, you know,